Hi and welcome to YT Knowledge Tree, and in this very quick demo I want to show you just how easy and how fast it is to make this program work and exactly what it can do for you. What can YT Knowledge Tree do? Well, YT Knowledge Tree can take any list of keywords and it will use our proprietary algorithm to calculate, to figure out exactly how easy those are to rank in YouTube. And it will sort those out for you. I'm going to show you exactly how you do that now. That's going to take a number of keywords. I'm going to paste them in here. Now, of course, these keywords could come from the Google Keyword Planner or from any keyword tool you like. And there's a load. You can actually upload CSV files to here so you can do exactly what you want. Now, what I've done here is I've taken a single keyword, in this case, sports shop. And I want to kind of focus on sports shops. So I've taken, in fact, every town in the West Midlands of the UK, if you're not familiar with the UK, West Midlands is an area of the UK, and I've just taken a list of each of the towns, like Aldridge, Bilston, Birmingham, Blackheath, etc., that are in the West Midlands. So I've got one particular area of the country, and I'm going to look at sports shops. So I've just put in here Aldridge sports shop, Bilston sports shop, etc. It's all the same keyword. So let's go and watch this YT Knowledge Tree program do exactly what it can do at its best. I simply press search and it will go straight off, and you see it's getting a video list for Aldridge Sports Shop. And what it does, it actually analyzes the top five videos in every one of those searches. So it will run the keyword into YouTube, it will pull the top five videos back, and it will run a huge amount of comparisons, and it will come back with a specific number that tell us exactly how hard or how easy that is to rank. And it'll order them for us. See, that's now finished grabbing all those top five videos. And now it's just going to go off and analyze those videos for us before it gives us the results. And that's nearly finished analyzing now. And any second now, we'll just pop up our results. Okay, that's our results now showing. And as you can see, we have all our keywords: Fordbridge Sports Shop, Pelsall Sports Shop, Cradley Heath Sports Shop, etc. And if we look over here on the far right hand side, we can see the competition. We'll see it's in kind of ascending competition. It's the lowest competition at the top. This particular one has a competition of zero, so you're absolutely guaranteed page one of Google and number one in YouTube. In fact, if you look at these 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.5, 0.8, you'll see they go up higher and higher as we go down the list to 1.2, 1.3, etc. And obviously, the higher these up, the tougher they get. Now, in general, anything that's one or under is, you don't even need any SEO with this. You can just put your video up and it will rank number one in YouTube and it will rank on the first page of Google. And anything under kind of 1.5, again, is pretty easy. Guaranteed to rank number one in YouTube and probably on the first page of Google as well. As we go up the scale, then things get tougher. These will take more to rank, but with a small amount of SEO, you can get that first page of Google. So I'll just explain a little bit more about this so you can see what's going on. As you can see, what it's done, it's taken not only the main keyword, in this case, Fordbridge Sports Shop, it's also split out the individual keywords, Fordbridge Shop and Sports, and it's compared all these with the top five videos that it returned for that search in YouTube. And I say that's where it creates that competition from. You also see here, you can see the number of dislikes, you can see the number of likes, how many views these videos have had on average. These are all average numbers here of the top five, and the actual average rating. Now, you can't see anything here at the moment, but because I just put the keywords in there directly myself. But if you import those keywords from the Google Keyword Planner, you'll also have the estimated price per click and the monthly average search volumes as well. So you can get some idea of the kind of value of those keywords. Now, I personally don't worry too much about those numbers when it comes to videos, but for those of you that like to see those numbers, I've put them in there for you. Okay, I've explained how it works. Let me go and show you the proof that it does.